Hello viewers, today in this video I will be talking about the cervical intraepithelial neoplasia. But before going through the animation, let's go through some basic points about the cancer of cervix. Cervical cancer is a cancer of female reproductive system and the most common cancer in women. It is usually caused by human papilloma virus. Cervix is also called as the neck of the uterus and it protrudes into the vagina. The anterior cavity of the cervix is also known as cervical canal. The cervix consists of two parts. The endocervix is the part closer to the uterus and is lined by columnar cells that produce mucus. And next is the ectocervix, that is continuous with the vagina and lined by mature squamous epithelial cells. Now, let's move ahead to cervical intraepithelial neoplasian or CIN. Cervical intraepithelial neoplasia, CIN, means dysplasia in the epithelial layer of the cervix. Depending upon the thickness of the epithelium involved by the tumor cells, cervical intraepithelial neoplasia is divided into CIN1, CIN2, and CIN3. Now, as you can see in this animation, the left side of the model shows the normal squamous epithelial lining seen in cervical epithelium for comparison with the neoplastic changes of increasing severity as you move to the right. Please note that the neoplastic changes are reversible in all the stages of cervical intraepithelial neoplasia, CIN, except for stage of invasive carcinoma. The tendency of reversibility to normal or more milder dysplasia decreases as one moves from milder to severely dysplastic lesions. As you see, the normal squamous epithelium in case of cervix is multi-layered with gradual maturation of squamous epithelium from basal region to superficial region until it is exfoliated off. As seen in the video, the basal layer is more cuboidal with the gradual transition to more flattened cell in the superficial layers. Now focusing on the mild type of pre-malignant changes in the cervical epithelium, also otherwise called cervical intraepithelial neoplasia 1 or mild dysplasia. You can see involvement of basal or deeper one-third of the epithelium. As you are moving down the thickness of this epithelium, you can appreciate that the nucleus in the basal or deeper one-third of the epithelium is becoming more darker, larger, and irregularly shaped. Other changes which are not seen in this video but are evident in dysplastic epithelium are loss of polarity, hyperchromasia, and pleomorphism. Increased nucleocytoplasmic ratio and increased mitosis, both typical and atypical, are also the changes visible. Now you see CIN2 or moderate dysplasia. Moving down to the deeper layers, you can appreciate that lower two-thirds of the epithelium is involved with similar changes in nucleus as seen in CIN1, but these changes are of a moderately severe degree as compared to CIN1. Therefore, CIN2 is also known as moderate dysplasia. And now let's talk about severe dysplasia, which is also called cervical intraepithelial neoplasia 3 or CIN3 or carcinoma in situ or CIS. As you see in CIN3, there is full thickness epithelial involvement by tumor cells although some degree of superficial maturation is still present. Whereas in carcinoma in situ, the loss of maturation is more or less uniform across all the layers of the epithelium, and the resemblance to squamoid morphology is totally lost. Please observe that the deeper epithelium in both the cases, that is CIN3 or CIS, is still limited by the basement membrane. Now let's move further, talking about the most severe neoplastic change seen in cervical epithelium, that is the invasive carcinoma or cancer. The invasive carcinoma tumor cells breaches the basement membrane and invades the deeper stroma and blood vessels, and the nuclear and cytoplasmic changes are of markedly severe degree in all the layers as compared to the previous stages. Now I will give you some additional information about the diagnosis and prognosis of cervical intraepithelial neoplasia. As these are pre-invasive lesions, therefore if diagnosed in early stages, we can prevent its progression into cancer. Let's first come to the diagnosis part. Screening for pre-invasive stages is done using pap smear and human papilloma virus testing. The pap test involves collection of some cells from the cervical transformation zone with a brush. These cells are then examined under a microscope for dysplastic changes. If the pap test comes out positive for dysplasia, it may be followed by colposcopic guided punch biopsy from the suspicious area of the cervix. Now let's proceed to the prognosis of CIN lesions. The progression of CIN lesions through grades 1 to grade 3 to cancer does not necessarily follow a linear fashion. Most CIN spontaneously regress if left untreated. About 75% of CIN1 will regress within 1 year, 90% will regress within 2 years, about 50% of CIN2 cases will regress within 2 years without treatment. HPV vaccination is the only approach for primary prevention of both CIN and cervical cancer. So, this is all about CIN lesions in short. I hope you like this video.